Hello everyone, this is Austin Becker again, coming to you live from Alexandria, Minnesota. And today I'm pretty excited actually about the topic that I've created for you guys. I'm going to be having this as a two-part series. We're going to have the external factors and internal factors of why I am the way I am. And this will kind of be going through some of the things like my beliefs, things that have kind of, persuaded me to believe a certain thing, or my kind of viewpoint to different things, my perspective, things that made me who I am. And I think, this will be a kind of a really telling presentation as far as, kind of, again, some of my viewpoints, getting, for you guys kind of getting to know me better, what kind of my true background is and such, and kind of my overall story. And so we'll kind of get started. This will be part one of a two-part video that I'll be creating just specifically on this aspect of external factors. So let's get started. So the first aspect that has really impacted me over the years is going to be the church and faith aspect. So kind of as I talked about in my last video, there's definitely been some doubts for me personally about, the church, the Bible, kind of what I believe, is God truly what we think that he is, such things like that. And, I've been going to church and Sunday school very consistently since I was younger. I always kind of thought it was weird if people didn't go to church or didn't go to Sunday school. And, now getting older and stuff, there's definitely been more doubts and kind of losing touch with that overall church atmosphere and kind of, wondering, okay, is the church really who they say they are? Are they really in it for the right reasons? Are we going to church for the right reasons? Are we just by going to church, are we going to be saved, from our sins or different things like that? And so I really started to ponder these different questions upon myself, and I've kind of, done a lot of research on this. And, the only time when I truly feel connected, involved, really experiencing something is when I'm listening to music that's, Christian, or going to a Christian concert, or different things like that. Or when I was at the National Youth Gathering in New Orleans in 2016 with our local church here in town. And overall, that was just such a phenomenal experience connecting with kids. If you guys ever get a chance to do something like that and, go connect with a cause that you really believe in, or with people that you really enjoy, which again, we'll get to some of that stuff with my decade experiences in my internal video that I'm going to be producing. But, those are really just experiences that have really honed in on me, that it's just like, wow, I can have a great experience. This is still kind of God-related, but I'm really just here kind of, for the overall, enjoyment, the fun aspect of it. And, like I kind of talked about in the last video, the thing that's really kind of deterred me from really believing in the church, really believing in faith, and really believing in the Bible and what it says so much is the fact that I think people are just going through the motions. They're doing this just to be saved. They're not really in it for the right reasons. They don't really know what they're saying. They don't really know what they really truly believe. Or, if they were, we'll just say, held at like gunpoint or something, could they actually say like, yep, I 100% believe I'm going to heaven. I believe everything that's in the Bible is exactly true, word for word, such like that. And so, like I said, I have lost some faith in, God, in the church, in people in general, just because, people, again, you look around, especially during this time, during the coronavirus and different things that have been going on, politically, and you think to yourself, it's just like, are people in it for the right reasons? Are they in it for just, personal gain? Are they in it to help people? What are they truly in it for? And so that's, again, kind of what I ask, and this makes me, ask myself, what do I truly believe? And again, I believe that there is some sort of creator out there. I don't know, if you want to call him God, if you want to call him the universe, but I mean, again, everything is in such a specific system that it has to be created by somebody or something. But again, I just don't know if all those things are true, and this is kind of where I'm at in this point of my life, and this is kind of what I believe, and that's, again, why I think the way that I think about these certain topics. The next one that's going to be pretty important is going to be social media and just society in general, around this time with all the different technology and such. So growing up, since I was born again in 1999, I've kind of been, around computer screen related stuff pretty much since I was, born. I remember, downstairs in our basement that we always had a big box, computer screen, and it had like the Paint app that I would go play on, or different little games. For many of you in my class, probably remember, games like Putt-Putt Saves the Zoo or different things, that were very old, or like, Legoland or such, that was on the computer, and those were pretty fun. But it's just, it's like, I think that all this technology has definitely impacted us, whether it be positive or negative. For example, with social media, I'm on a few different pages like Facebook and such, especially with like releasing these videos and different things like YouTube. But you look around and you see like other people's situations and what they have, you know, materialistically wise, and you think to yourself, you're just like, okay, is this really what's going on? Is this really real? Because I think a lot of things that we see out there are really unrealistic. And, you know, you see other people's situations with their fancy cars. Maybe they have a fancy, you know, wedding. They have the perfect husband and wife. They have the perfect family. They have the perfect house. And you see all these things and you're just like, my life sucks. You know, I mean, you start thinking that to yourself. You're just like, you know, why can't my life be like this where I have all these things coming to me and things are happening great in my life and it's just a really good time versus, you know, where I'm kind of at. And I think that, you know, people, again, feed their addiction basically on social media. I mean, that's what I would call it. That they're looking for approval. They're looking for this, you know, they're trying to feel their self-image, which, I mean, I struggle with my self-image. I mean, I'm going to share that in the internal video again, kind of, you know, about the way that I think about that. But it's just, you know, it's like people are looking for those likes and those shares and those comments to kind of really feed that addiction and, you know, get that, you know, dopamine hit, which is the same thing that, you know, you get from alcohol or drug or different things like that. And so it truly is an addiction for a lot of people. And I think, too, you know, it's made our connections a lot different over the years, especially right now, you know, where we can't really be face-to-face with people so much as, you know, versus on a screen. The connections are very limited. You're, you know, always connecting over, you know, a phone or a tablet or a computer screen, even without all the virus stuff going on right now. I mean, I think it's just we've lost our personal connections, our personal touch with people, and I miss that. I think a lot of other people do as well, where they're, you know, missing that human interaction, they're missing that loving, caring friend to kind of lean on and such. And so that's kind of where I think about that. And I think that, you know, again, music and celebrities and news, all these different sites, you know, a lot of the social media just make things worse as far as, you know, giving us this image. You know, I think with a lot of, we'll just say like pop or country or different songs, you know, they have this image, we'll just say again, of like a perfect marriage, or we'll just say like you're perfect, you know, you're going down a road and you see somebody that's perfect on the side of the road and you pick them up and you guys go for a drive and, you know, you end up, you know, marrying like a week later or something. I mean, there's all these different scenarios that they make up in these different songs or with like your celebrities, and you kind of, you know, idolize these things. But again, what is truly real in our lives? What are you actually chasing after? And that's something that I think I'm going to get to again with the personal video with myself that's more on the internal side of things. And so with that, guys, I'm going to skip ahead now to part two. You guys can watch to kind of, you know, watch the rest of this video. Hope you guys really enjoyed the first half of this video. And again, just have a great rest of the day. We will see you very soon.